Today we're talking about Friday Black, but first, welcome to the video, welcome to today's video, welcome to Reading Between the Lines. I'm your host, Brandon, and this is the channel where I talk about books and things of that nature. Now, like I said, we're going to be talking about Friday Black today. This is one of my books on my January TBR. You can check that link right here to see what other books I'm going to be reading this month. But I finished this book, and I had no idea, absolutely no idea what I just read. Now, this is my first short story collection book that I have consumed. This one, author Nane Kwame Adegbenye. This has 12 short stories in it, and I only understood 5 of them. And what I use the term understood lightly because I kind of just knew what the story was talking about, or at least the main theme. I watched one of his interviews that he did over in Australia. It was like an hour-long video. I watched it, and he was talking about, like, at least the way it seemed to me was every story had a theme, and then a second theme, and then each one of those themes seemed to have sub-themes to them, and I could not grasp it for the life of me. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna tell you the stories that I did kind of get a grasp on, and then the other ones, I don't know, I can't talk about them, and I don't even know if I can say if this book is bad or good, simply because I just didn't understand most of it, and in doing so, I don't wanna you know, crap on this author, because it seems like he's my kind of guy in terms of thinking super deep, but I just don't think I have, I don't know, I just don't know, you know? So let's get started with the review. Okay, so the first story in this book is called The Finkelstein Five. And basically what I got out of this story, so the main character, he's able to change, he's a young black guy, he's able to change his blackness on a scale of 1 to 10, depending on the situation and depending on how he thinks other people are perceiving him in said situation. Now this part of the story I really related to, and I think most black people do. Again, my buddy Lionel, I'll put his channel over here and you can check it out. He's just like me, he's not fully black, but he does have to deal with these kinds of things in terms of, okay, how black can I be, or how black should I not be, or things like that. And so that part of the story I really related to. And the other part of the story just kind of shows the prejudice of the justice system on, I guess you could say, young black men, at least that's what's going on in the story. And it's kind of similar to like the whole Trayvon Martin thing, but except in this story, it's super like, it's like gruesome almost, and it's like it kind of just like throw things way like wow, that's insane. But I think he did that just because it's a story, and he just kind of wanted to highlight the whole concept of it and make it as brutal as possible, I guess, just so the reader can get a nice I guess picturing of what it's like. And I can't give away any details really, because it just destroys, it spoils the story. What I do want to say really quick, and I just thought of this right before I pressed record, is that the way these short stories are written is kind of like cartoons that I watched back in the day, like Tom and Jerry. Like, no episodes, at least from my memory, no episodes were really linked together. There was no, like, there was no storyline. It was just things happening on different episodes. Same thing with, like, SpongeBob or Jimmy Neutron. I mean, the theme was kind of there, but there wasn't any, like, there was no bridge between episodes, at least from my memory. And maybe there was, but I don't know. And that's kind of what it seemed like. So it was weird. Now that I thought about that, it's weird that I couldn't grasp what was going on here. And maybe it was just because this guy is too deep of a thinker for me, which again is another reason why I want to read. But I'm babbling. So the next story is called Friday Black. Kind of a spin on Black Friday. You know, the event, at least in the USA, it's called Black Friday. The event where everyone goes out and buys things for super discounted prices and they go crazy, I'm sure. If you're watching this, you've probably seen a video of people fighting each other at Walmart for a TV or a dresser or a pair of shoes or whatever. He made that this story, but he put so much extra sauce on it, like almost unnecessarily. The way the story was put together, I thought was completely brilliant. So there's this underlying theme that I caught just as I was finishing the story, and that he pointed out in the interview that I watched after I got done reading the book. And it's this whole relationship between like consumerism and love, and how people think, I'm guilty of this, how people think if they buy something for somebody, then that person that they bought the product for will love them because of them buying that. And that's a very toxic way of thinking. But I think it's just the way people in America were kind of raised. Like, you work hard and you buy things and that's it. And it's cool, but to a certain extent, you know, right? It only makes you so happy. Those items only last for so long. You can only use them so long. Your body lasts so long. Things like that. And I thought that was a very, very important subject for him to point out. So hopefully if you read this book, well, actually I already told you, but if someone is reading this book and they didn't watch a review on it, hopefully they can pick that up, because I think that's very poisonous. Kind of like a sugar daddy, right? Like, a sugar daddy is going to buy his girl toy, whatever you want to call her, a car, a house, is going to give her $100,000 a month. And you think that that's going to buy her love, which it's not. It's just gonna spoil her. It's just gonna make her think that you're just a source for her getting materialistic things. So I think it's really poisonous, but like I said, I'm gonna try not to babble because it's really hard. But that's a very, very beautiful topic that he pointed out and brought up in that story. Now, the third story that I got a grasp of is called Zimmerland. And the concept of this story is that there's this, I don't know if it's a virtual reality thing or if it's a theme park. I didn't really understand that part, but it's this system in which people can pay to come and kill bad guys. But the way it seems in the book is it's like people want to come and kill black people. Basically, racism as a sport. And I mentioned this in my last, in the January TBR video. That's one of the things that really drew me to grab this book, because that's like a very interesting topic, right? Like someone is willing to pay money to get a virtual gun or virtual knife or whatever it is to go kill the person they hate the most in real life. Like, people do this, people get rid of anger in certain ways, you know, drinking, doing drugs, playing video games, doing carpentry, painting their nails. Like, people get rid of anger so many ways. But this is like the way he projected that idea of people ridding of anger in Zimmerland was like, whoa. Like, that's a big conversation to be had, because I remember I was like maybe 13 or 14, maybe even younger, maybe 12. And I was at a buddy's house and his mom came home from work. I mean, we were playing like this hockey game, and in this hockey game, you can initiate fights like they do in real life, but you could actually initiate it. I forget the name of the game. I forget what year it was or whatever, but she would come home from work and she would be stressed and she'd be like, all right, let me get on that game. And we have to give her the controller, and then she would initiate fights and just take out all of her anger through the controller into the virtual athletes and have as they're fighting, and she would release her anger that way. So it kind of makes sense, and I kind of got a real, like, that kind of hooked me, just because I've experienced it before. Like, I'd be angry and I would simply just want to come home, not talk to anybody, play Call of Duty, which is cool, but it's like the only missing link there is that I'm not trying to destroy something specific. I'm rather just trying to release my anger into winning a match and like upgrading my, like leveling up my guy or my profile or whatever. So like I said, there's that missing link, and that missing link is very, it's very deep. And I can make a whole video on that. I could, maybe not a whole video, but I can have a whole discussion probably with my guy Lionel. I'm probably gonna talk to him about it. But like, it's just crazy to think about that. Like, racism as a sport, give me money, here's your simulation, go kill that guy, whoever you wanna kill, whether it's a black person, a purple person, a gold person, whatever. It's a crazy thing to think about. Very crazy. Okay. This fourth story, it's called Lark Street. And when I tell you, let me make sure I'm a friend. When I tell you, it was weird, like weird, okay? It's about a couple who aborted their little people. And these aborted children were haunting their parents. I got the concept, but holy That's a weird story, man. Like, it was weird. I was reading, I was like, what the fuck is happening? Very weird story called Lark Street. If you want to read it, check it out. But yeah, that's weird. Okay, finally, the fifth story that I got a grasp on. It's so funny because I can't even say I understand them. But fifth story that I got a grasp on is called Through the Flash, if I'm not mistaken. Let me double check my notes here. Yes, Through the Flash, the very last story. I thought this one was actually pretty cool. It's basically about this town, this little community that it's like they're living in a loop, and the loop lasts for one day, I guess you could say. And at the end of the day, there's a big nuclear blast and it comes and blows up and kills everybody, but everybody comes back to life the following day. And they can remember everything that happened before the nuclear blast and the previous section to the loop. And it kind of just shows like this, I think she's like a 14 year old black girl. I could be 100% wrong, but I'm pretty sure she's a 14 year old black girl. And she's kind of like the badass in the story. And it kind of shows like the corrections that people make to themselves based upon their previous day in the loop. Like, if that makes any sense at all. I think it was a good story, it's a great concept. That's basically all I know about the story. Like I said, I got a grasp on it. I think it's a good book, overall. Like, I'm not gonna give it a bad score. Like, I still have to create a Goodreads account. And when I rate it on there, I'm not gonna give it a bad score at all, because it's my own reasoning that I can't understand the book. Or the stories, I should say. So I think what's going on here in my brain is I just need to do a little bit more understanding of culture, because I think that's what this book kind of tackles. It's like it comes across as just weird and like kind of all over the place. But I think the main theme is to kind of just talk about things that are going on in our culture. I think over here in America, and I think that's a good thing. I think that's a good thing to talk about. It's kind of a good way to open the doors of discussion with a book like this that's really creative, really exaggerated, and kind of does show like what's going on, again, in a very exaggerated manner. If I had to recommend this book to somebody, yes, I'd say read it. It's, like I said, it's a short book. It's not too long. It's like 190 pages or something. Probably gonna rate it, I don't know, probably like a 3.5 out of 5 stars, until I reread it again, or at least reread the stories I didn't understand again. I think he's a good author. I do want to read more of his books. I'm not even sure if he has other books out, but definitely in the future, just because of the way he thought about the stories in this book really, really intrigued me. So that's it. That's my Friday Black Review by Nana Adjei. I'm never gonna get this guy's name right. By Nana Kwame Adjei-Brenya. And that's it. It's the whole review. Did you answer the question? Do you like short story collections? I like to ask questions to engage with my viewers so I can make friends and build a cool community. Thumbs up, dudes. Anyways, I'm out. Wait, like the video if you liked it. Comment if you want to talk about it. And subscribe. Join the squad that reads between the lines. I'm out.